don't think the theater is supposed to be grand like this. You know, you enter, it's like the whole team.
Hey, yeah, boy, yeah.
Hello, xin chào các bạn đã đến với kênh của Koi và
Kelly.
Hôm nay là ngày rất là đặc biệt. Hôm nay là ngày đầu tiên Koi với Kelly trở lại đi coi phim ở rạp hát. So, what are we watching today?
We're watching Dad, I'm Sorry. I don't know what it is in Vietnamese.
It is Bố Già. Thì Bố Già của đạo diễn Trấn Thành, anh Trấn Thành và anh Vũ Ngọc Đảng. Thì Koi có coi Bố Già series. It's like a web series on YouTube. I've seen the series.
You've seen it?
Yeah, it's really good. It's about relationship between the father and what sacrifices the father has to do for like a for a family in Vietnam.
Oh, okay.
Right?
Can we still watch it on YouTube?
I think so.
Oh, really?
Yeah, but they made a film, and it's shown in America, which is like really good. Cho nên, it's really exciting, right? So, cho nên hôm nay Koi với Kelly đi tới rạp hát để ủng hộ anh Trấn Thành và anh Vũ Ngọc Đảng. Sunny, why are we going to the movie theater, Kelly?
Well, we are hoping that if we came during the afternoon that there would be less people. And even though we have been vaccinated, we just kind of want to be extra safe.
Yeah.
And maybe we'll just have the theater to ourselves. This is the first time we've been back to the movie theater.
That's
since
right.
Before the pandemic started.
But it's
right?
Kind of ironic because you go to the movie theater, you want to watch it with a group of people, but we're going back to the movie theater hopefully to not watch it with anyone.
Intentionally, yeah. To have it to ourselves.
If it works out, we have the whole theater to ourselves.
Yeah, I guess we'll find
out. But I do want a lot of people seeing. So I think it's been very popular. All of our Vietnamese friends here in San Diego have seen this movie.
Well, and they were only supposed to have it showing for like a week, right?
Yeah.
And it just keeps getting extended,
yeah.
And extended, so I think it's doing really well,
yeah.
Which is great. We're
and
so
excited.
Happy about that,
yeah.
And we want to catch it before it goes. We don't know when it's going to go now.
That's
yeah.
Right. You know what's funny, Kelly?
What?
Very ironic. So, this movie that we're watching at this theater is mm-hmm. called, what do you call it?
Well, they translated
Daddy
to Dad, I'm Sorry.
Dad, I'm Sorry. Oh yeah, right? Koi với Kelly đã coi một cái phim Việt Nam khác ở rạp hát này ở trong một cái Asian Film Festival ở San Diego tên là Goodbye Mother.
Mm.
So the other Vietnamese film that we're watching in this same
That's
movie
right.
theater is called Goodbye Mother. And today we're watching another Vietnamese film called I'm Sorry Daddy.
That's
so
right. Oh, and when we watched Goodbye Mother, one of the actresses was here,
That's
right?
Right.
And you got to it's take a picture with her.
Hồng Đào, chị Hồng Đào.
Yeah,
phải có Khôi phải nói cô Hồng Đào. Chị Hồng Đào, yeah, Khôi có chụp phần, Khôi với Khôi có chụp phần với chị Hồng Đào ở đây. Tại vì chị Hồng Đào là một cái một diễn viên chính. Chị ấy play, chị ấy đóng vai người mẹ trong cái phim Goodbye Mother, right?
That one was really good.
Yeah.
I like that one a lot.
Yeah, so we're just supporting Vietnamese cinema in America here.
Yeah, absolutely,
yeah.
For sure.
Like you guys all know that Kelly and I really like to watch movies. So let's see if we can get the tickets to watch this movie today.
Let's go.
All right. Các bạn, rạp hát này là tên là Edward Cinema. Các bạn thấy rạp hát này là rất rất là to luôn. Hình như rạp hát này là trong những rạp hát lớn nhất ở San Diego ở đây. Thì bây giờ Koi với Kelly đi vô sẽ quay cho các bạn xem như thế nào. Koi và Kelly tới sớm quá cho nên này là sức đầu tiên sớm quá, họ chưa chuẩn bị xong, họ chưa mở cửa luôn. Tại vì rạp hát ở bên đây họ mới bắt đầu mở lại cho nên mọi việc thì hơi chậm chút xíu.
Huh?
Disagree.
Okay.
I'm saying we came too early and they still haven't opened.
Yeah.
And the theater here, they just opened up, so everything's too kind of slow. They're getting, the workers getting used to it.
Oh, maybe that's right. It's a nice plaza, though, right?
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Lots of pretty flowers and palm trees.
Yeah.
And
so this area is called Mira Mesa.
Mm-hmm.
Mira Mesa, các bạn, thì cũng có nhiều khu đây cũng gần cũng như là gần khu châu Á. Có rất là nhiều nhà hàng và tiệm tạp hóa châu Á ở đây.
feel like if you live around here, you have everything you need, because they have the movie theater, they have a bunch of restaurants, they have Meat Fresh, In-N-Out.
They have a bookstore.
Bookstore, gas station,
everything in
store,
San Diego you need.
Everything you need, all in
this area.
They have
a Costco near here, too.
Do they really?
Yeah, it was Carmichael, no?
No.
Just like up north
wild.
A lot.
Yeah, they have everything then.
Yeah. So, what do you feel about watching Vietnamese movie, Kelly?
I enjoy watching Vietnamese movies.
Why?
I mean, the ones that we've seen so far, they're really good. You
what
know?
Do you like about it?
They're
What's different?
They're very real, you know? Like, very, you feel like you're really experiencing, like, you kind of get to really understand, like, what families, like, experience, you know, from a different culture's perspective.
So, a lot of drama right now is, like, family drama, huh? Because last time was, like, goodbye, mommy, and now it's, like, sorry, daddy.
Yeah.
So, Vietnamese are very, like,
family-oriented. They always include comedy as well. There's always some, like, comic relief, you know?
Yeah, it has to have some entertainment.
For sure.
With the drama, right?
But what sometimes I think is disappointing is that sometimes the translations are not very clear, you know? So I have to have you, like, explain them to me.
Well, that's the same with us doing the subtitle.
Yeah, that's right.
Sometimes, like, có nhiều từ ngữ của tiếng Anh á, các bạn mình không có thể dịch là tiếng Việt. Và ngược lại cũng như vậy, có nhiều từ ngữ tiếng Việt mình dịch là tiếng Anh thì nó vô duyên lắm. Right?
Yeah.
So, a lot of phrases, you just can't translate. You just have to understand the culture.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
Oh,
they're open. Let's go. Họ mở cửa rồi, bây giờ đi vô cho các bạn xem. Hy vọng có thể quay được. Nhiều khi họ không cho mình quay trong trọng.
Wow.
Vẫn các bạn. Bây giờ mình phải mua vé ở đây.
Wow, it's so grand.
See, I think the theater is supposed to be grand like this. You know, you enter, it's just like the whole experience.
Mm-hmm.
It's like going to like Hollywood or going to a big show. You sure his hair cut?
Mm-hmm. I think it's one thing to do.
Oh, and it's cheaper because it's afternoon, right?
Matinee, so it's like first showing.
So the red,
red
is that's
available.
The screen, right? So, there's a social distancing.
Yes, you can't sit there.
Should we sit here? No, we should sit here.
There's someone here.
Yeah, but we should sit here.
Okay,
you shouldn't sit too far back. Right? Okay. Thanks. Hi, yeah, boy, yeah. Xong, bây giờ đợi tới 2 giờ mấy đây con.
Okay, since we have some time to kill.
Còn 30 phút để chờ tới xuất phim, cho nên bây giờ coi với Kelly đi uống nước trà sữa. Wait, is this milk tea or just like fruit tea?
They have fruit tea and milk tea, I think. Most places have both.
It's called taste tea.
Taste tea.
All right, so we got our tea with strawberry and peach.
Yes.
Peach me.
Peach yeah. me.
So bữa nay trời nắng tốt, uống trà với trái cây để giải khát. It's better than drinking soda.
I wish they sold this in the movie theater. Right, so you can bring it in, or they let you. I wish they let you bring it in.
Well, I used to work in the movie theater, and I know reason why certain things are not sold in the movie theater.
So why is that?
Like if this thing spills,
it's very sticky.
It'd be very hard to clean up because it has like bits and pieces in it.
That's true.
Yeah,
and it's very well soda sticky too.
Yeah, because we want to sell something that is like super easy to like clean up because people are very messy. You know?
Are people very messy?
Mm-hmm.
Do people always bring in their own food and drinks and stuff?
Yeah.
Are you allowed to tell them no? Like, what if they go out to eat and they have leftovers?
If you see it, you can tell them
that
they're not allowed.
Mm-hmm.
But they shouldn't let you see it. And the whole point is like if you bring something in and it's visible and people see it, right? If they let you in, then they have to let other people bring their own stuff in.
Yeah,
that's why I just don't let them see it.
I've brought in like pad thai before the restaurant. It was so good.
I mean, I think it's fine as long as you like clean up.
I don't make a mess.
Like, we can't force you to not bring anything in.
Yeah.
That's right.
Because some theaters that are located in the city, like, you don't go back to your car, you don't go home, you go out to eat, you have leftover food, and then, you know, you're smelling it, and you're like, wow, I want more of my pad thai.
Yeah.
So.
But the thing is, concession is how movie theater makes money.
Honestly, I love movie theater popcorn.
Yeah. I used to make the best popcorn at the movie theater.
You were the popcorn king?
It was the popcorn king.
What was the most popular snack at the movie theater? Popcorn or candy?
Popcorn.
Popcorn? What's the most popular candy?
The thing about popcorn is because people can't bring that in. Like, they can't bring good popcorn.
Yes, the only, they can.
But the best place you can get popcorn is from a movie theater because they pop it fresh.
That's true.
And everything just fresh.
Man, they're making me want popcorn. Yeah. Maybe we should go grab some chopsticks from that Chinese place. To go chopsticks.
Pick up stick.
And then we go get popcorn and we can use the chopsticks to eat our popcorn.
I feel like by the time we finish this, we'll be full.
Really?
Well, it's up to you. You want popcorn? We can get popcorn.
Yeah, it's been so long since we've had popcorn in a movie theater. I feel like we should do it up. Do it right.
I mean, it could be that those popcorn has been sitting there for a whole year. Stale.
It's in a kernel. I don't think it gets stale.
It does,
really.
Man.
Really?
Yeah, we have an expiration date in that kernel.
They're not going to feed everybody stale popcorn at their first like experience back then. Everyone's going to be like, yeah, I'm not coming back to this movie theater.
You never know.
No. Can you ask them to taste test it first?
Again?
Why not? Be like, oh.
I'm just very excited that we get to watch a Vietnamese film in America.
Yeah, and this theater is big.
Because...
Right? The screen is very big.
And plus, back in the day, this is something that is not possible.
To watch a Vietnamese movie in America.
Yeah, now I think it's just easier.
Mm-hmm.
Because everything is digital, you know?
Yeah. Is the movie industry growing in Vietnam? Would you say?
I think so, and there's more movies now.
I hope so.
I mean, this past 2 years, we already saw it. This is the second one.
What's that other one we saw where that girl, she's finding her daughter or her son?
Oh, Fury. That's on Netflix.
Yeah, that one was
good,
too.
That was with Ngô Thanh Vân.
Yeah, that one was good, too. We like that. We watched that on... No, we watched that in the theater.
Really? No, we watched it on Netflix. Well, where did we watch it in the theater?
I feel like we watched it at this theater.
Really? No, we watched the...
Oh, we watched it on
Goodbye
Netflix.
Mother in this theater.
I know we watched that one, but I thought we watched Fury here now, too. No?
Mm-mm. Well, the director, Vũ Ngọc Đảng, he made a series, he made a TV show called Bỗng Nhiên Muốn Khóc.
What does that mean?
Suddenly I Want to Cry. Yeah. And at that time, that show was like really good. Mm-hmm. Because I think all the Vietnamese shows at that time, that one really stood out.
Okay.
Yeah, like the quality of the direction, like the way he directed and how it was like filmed. Mm. It was like really like fresh and like new.
Oh, okay.
And it's very emotional, like it's very good. So I feel like that's why An Chung Thanh and invite Mr. Vu Ngoc Dang to direct this, co-direct this with him, because he knows that Mr. Vu Ngoc Dang can like bring the emotion out.
Oh, I yeah. see. That's
so
cool.
maybe people will cry in this film. I heard people cry a lot from this
really?
Film. Yeah.
I shouldn't have worn mascara.
Yeah. Did you wear mascara?
Well, I wore the waterproof thing. It should be okay. Can I have some too?
Yeah. Well, we're gonna finish this up, and we may or may not get popcorn. And then we're gonna watch the movie, and then we're gonna tell you guys what we think mm-hmm. afterwards.
Yeah, I think it's time to go, right? I can't turn. Oh, we should probably head
okay,
back.
Okay, alright.
Alright, we'll see you at the movies. So, we're definitely getting popcorn.
What else gonna get for you guys? Just a small popcorn? Yeah. Instead of 29, please. Thank you. There you are, you guys enjoy. Yeah.
Just here to pick through the Reblov's life. Wow, you guys. Wow. What a great movie to come back to the movie theater
yeah.
to in over a year,
that's
right?
That's right. I think this is a really good movie. I'm proud that I watched this movie as the first movie to come back to a movie theater.
Me too.
From the pandemic. It's been over a year.
It's been over a year. Babe, can you
yeah.
tell me what you liked about it?
Wow, the movie is like a roller coaster ride in like emotion, right?
It is.
It's like it makes you cry and it makes you laugh like right away, and it like plays with your emotion
so quickly.
Yeah,
their timing is just
yeah.
excellent. Like the line between the drama and
yeah.
you know the lightheartedness.
Yeah,
I think that's really challenging to do in films. You
yeah.
know, without like really like. Either the timing is a few seconds too late or a few seconds too early, and they just have
yeah.
it. It's perfect.
Yeah. The movie
yeah.
was so good.
No, I don't.
Like,
I'm like struggling to talk about it because I don't
yeah.
want to give away too much. I want everyone to go see it,
yeah.
right?
Các bạn, the movie, cái phim mình biết mình nó hay là rất là dễ các bạn. Mình coi cái phim đó mà mình không thấy nó dài, nhưng mà mình khi mà nó hết mình cũng muốn coi thêm nữa. Cái tình trạng đó là cái tình trạng mà mình coi cái phim.
And I want to say that I believe that the relationships that they built with
yeah.
the family is just like spot on.
Yeah.
It felt so real. Like I didn't think, oh, I'm watching a movie and it's like dramatized because of this or that. You know, they're making it more of like
yeah.
for a movie. It felt very real. So I believe that the directing and the acting and the script all came together
yeah.
to create
it was...
magic here because it was so perfect.
Yeah.
It was flawless, honestly.
Yeah. I just love that it shows like it captures society, the Vietnamese society in this moment in time,
mm-hmm.
like in like the year 2021,
mm-hmm.
right? How like you have like the nice fancy building in the background, but like Vietnamese family are living in like an alleyway that are like so close knit. And like the one thing that is very special was that the street was always wet. You know, like
if
that's
it's
something
not flooding, it's
yeah,
still wet.
That's something that like you don't see a lot in movies, but that is it is like that in Vietnam.
Yeah.
Like sometimes it's flood, sometimes like it's
like
dry.
They thought
it's
of,
always wet.
Like they always
yeah, it's
they
so
captured
real.
It really
yeah,
really
like
well.
It's for entertaining, but it's also very like like memorable.
It's a good timestamp. Right?
Yeah, it's a good timestamp. Like, it's a movie worth like watching even like 10 years from now, 20 years from now, because you would know like what the society is like.
That's right.
In the, you know, 21st century of Vietnam, right?
And how it's changing.
Yeah, like,
and
you know
how it's being influenced.
Like the son, like his career is like YouTubing and live
streaming. Don't give away too much.
No,
okay, okay. I know. I just get nervous.
Right?
Yeah.
And the it just like you feel like that's Vietnam right there.
Boy's speechless right now, and I know this means that he just was like, I'm so happy. It was such a good movie.
So what was your favorite scene, Kelly?
Okay, I don't...
Spoiler alert, New Magabang.
No, I don't want to give a spoiler alert.
No, it is, so we tell them, ahead of hand, like, I'm pretty sure they've seen this movie.
Okay, all right, but
so,
I don't want to...
What's your favorite scene?
I love the scene where the... So what's the main actor's name, Vietnamese name?
Jung Tan.
Jung Tan, where he's sitting
the
with...
The father, right?
The father.
Yeah.
He's sitting with...
The tailor lady.
The tailor lady. And they have this,
what is her name? Golay? Is it Lay?
Oh yeah, Golay.
Yeah, it's Golay, right? Mm-hmm.
And
Gomaido.
They have this like relationship that's been going on, and they finally talk about it. But it's like it's hilarious. It was
I love
so
that
hilarious and also touching, and also like it was just a good, really great
scene. I love that scene. It plays with like relationship for older adults,
mm-hmm.
like mature adult, right?
Yeah.
That we don't see that often in like, you know, like in movies or like Vietnamese movie, right?
Yeah.
And I just love the fact that at the end it like flips. It's kind of like
it flips so fast. And you just like
he was assuming that she's like weak, like lady, like or like.
No, he was assuming
that she would be complaining that you know life with him would be so like bad.
That life he didn't want to bring make her life like more difficult.
Yeah.
He didn't want to be responsible for that.
But he's assuming that she's weak and like you know like can't do that, but like she turned around, she's like, why do you think that I'm weak? Like I'm like it shows that like, you know, women like can be very strong,
mm-hmm.
and then they fight for their love. I really like her character.
Yeah, I love her character.
Yeah.
And I love the fact that the movie covers all different types of relationships.
Yeah. What was the scene that made you cry? Or like I'm sure there are many scenes that made us cry, but what are the memorable ones?
There are many that made me cry. There are two that stick out though. One is when the son, the last time he saw the family, he kind of bashed them really hard.
Is that the one where he's kneeling down?
The one where he started
to
kneel down. So then he has to go back to them after the last time he saw them. So it's very uncomfortable. And he has this crisis in his house that he has to help solve. And he's like basically begging them for their help. And they're really torn because, of course, they want to help, but it's a really sticky situation, you know?
Yeah.
And the family just kind of feels the burden all at one time of like how intense this one thing that's happening, how intense it's affecting the entire family, or how intense it is for the entire family. So that scene is really heartbreaking. And the thing is what I loved about it is that the family didn't care too much about what had just happened. Like they were just focusing on the struggle that they were worried about at that moment. They weren't like, oh, we're not going to help you because the last time this and that. They were just like, of course we want to help you, of course, but you have to understand like the situation that you're putting us in. It's very sticky.
Yeah.
And then the second one was when the dad and the son like fight about donating the kidney.
No, it's spoiler. We're doing a spoiler alert.
Okay.
Right? Because we have to like talk with people who've seen it.
Okay.
As well, you know?
Fine. Okay. I want to know, what scene made you cry though?
Well, there are many scenes that made us cry, but the one that memorable is the scene where Jung Tan, the grandfather, speak to the granddaughter.
Oh.
Right? And he's like, love your father because he loves me very much.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah.
Like that scene is so simple, but like it just like wow, like
that was a good
it
one.
Just like makes you like it just hit that spot, right?
Mm-hmm.
And another one that I thought that like really meant that is very meaningful was when he asked people like, do you have a picture with your dad?
Yeah.
You know, like I challenge you, when's the last picture you have with your dad, right? And I remember like growing up it was always the dad that takes the family photo.
That's right.
And he never has like photo of himself like
That's
my
right.
dad and your grandparents,
mm-hmm.
right?
That's right?
Or your grandpa.
Mm-hmm.
So I do feel that message to the viewer, like you should have photos with your parents,
mm-hmm.
you know, your
Absolutely.
Mom and your dad,
yeah.
you know, because when you're in that point where he needed the photo the most, he didn't have it. And that's when he appreciated it the most.
That's right.
So like, you know, like I think that scene like made me realize, wow, like that's that hit the spot too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, for yeah. sure, for sure. Many, many tears. And
yeah, many
laughs.
Tears, many laughs too. It's so crazy. That, like, I think it affected me more because I like don't have to read the subtitle. Like, how was it with you? Like, understanding the movie with the subtitle.
I thought
versus
it was fine.
Reading it.
I thought it was fine. I think I can see some things that translate. That maybe don't translate clearly, but I know what they're trying to say.
Yeah.
So I don't get stuck on like, yeah. oh, that's not right. I'm just like, oh, I get what they're saying.
Yeah.
So, and when you know the story and you're into the story, I feel like it keeps making sense.
Yeah.
You know, like the story just kind of tells itself.
But the family conflict, it's like, do you relate to that or is it the same or is it different, like,
I mean,
culturally?
Everybody
or do you think
family.
That's universal?
I think it's universal. I mean,
but the
maybe
conflict
the way
that
it looks or the type of conflicts they
yeah.
have are different. But
yeah.
everybody has conflict for sure
yeah.
in their family.
Remember that actress that has like all those roles?
She was honestly hilarious.
She was so
honestly,
funny.
At first
but
you don't
I feel bad for
first,
her.
At first you don't like her, but then like then you realize like she legitimately thinks
she played that role really well.
She legitimately
too.
Thinks she's doing everybody a favor.
Yeah.
She because even when
she's
the dad and
honest.
The son are fighting at one point when the dad is like, I don't know if I'll make it, she's like, don't be so pessimistic. Like,
I think she's the most honest. Like she
just
speaks.
She's literally
just
speaking
yeah.
the truth.
She's like hiding nothing.
Yeah, hiding.
You know,
like
I love,
hurtful sometimes, but like, you know.
I love her wardrobe because she reminds me of that lady from Kung Fu Hustle.
Oh, that's right.
The boss lady
she's
that
very
talks
honest
a lot.
Too.
Yeah.
yeah. Mm-hmm.
So and I love like the wardrobe how like they have all this colorful.
Yeah.
And he was remember when he was yelling like the son was yelling at her right and she was like you're just like all those colorful roles in your head
yeah.
you're so many you have so many face
yeah.
you know and I was like wow like that's that fit with her wardrobe when that happened I was
that's
like
crazy.
That's
does,
a good
she's
yeah.
she's actually a really good character
yeah
I ended up really I didn't like her at first and then I ended up really liking her you know?
Yeah I feel like you would enjoy the series,
yeah.
the web series.
I really want to watch it, but I need subtitles though.
That's true.
Because they talk so fast.
Maybe they do.
Like
have
I
subtitles.
Can pick up on the simple vocabulary that I know, but
yeah.
they talk so fast. I can't like I wouldn't know what was happening
yeah.
at all.
But maybe they do have subtitles.
Yeah, we should look and see.
Yeah.
Yeah. If you haven't seen it,
there's just
like,
so much.
Do
more.
Yourself a favor and check it out. Right.
Yeah. There's just so much more that like we could talk about.
I know, but we have to
movie.
Wait. We have to
but
wait.
But overall, I do feel
anybody.
That like everyone who's involved in this movie should feel proud.
Yeah.
Because this movie is something that, you know, will last a long time, and people will rewatch it because it's just.
I'm ready
to
rewatch it already.
Yeah. It's that
so good.
I mean, maybe because like. I love today. Like today, like first time we've been back to the movie theater and we watched like a really good movie. Like, you know, a day when you watch a good movie, you just feel good about like, damn, I watched a good movie today.
Yeah.
And it happened to be in the theater with like a good experience.
I know.
Yeah.
It
so
was
how was
really
your popcorn?
Great.
Did you like your popcorn?
The popcorn was good. The popcorn you used to make at your old place was much better.
I was too busy watching the movie that I forgot
I know.
To eat the popcorn.
Well, we have it still.
Yeah.
I kept the chopsticks. So the chopsticks were good. To have to eat it.
Yeah.
The movie theater wasn't very full. There was maybe four other people.
That's
with
right.
us? Four
yeah.
or six, maybe? I don't know. It was a really small amount of people.
Yeah. Also, it's so weird to come out of the movie theater and it's still sun.
I know, the sun is
like we
like
normally
burning.
Watch the movie, we come out and it's like late at night.
I
you
know
what I mean?
I know.
But it's different times, right?
It is.
Maybe one day
times.
We'll watch movies with a crowded theater again.
It would be
I can't
fun.
Wait.
It is fun, honestly.
Yeah.
When you're watching a really good movie and the whole audience
yeah.
is reacting, you can feel it.
Yeah, 양콜롭다타디가시네, right? We really love seeing the movie. So, anything
yeah.
else you want to
before
add?
We give away too much, I think we should just, you
that's
know.
True. I'm
yeah.
pretty sure everyone who's watching this have seen the movie.
Okay, but then we can
but
talk
if you
about
haven't
it
seen,
and then later.
누가 많이 키울 커피 나니까 많이 영 디오 랩핵 내 커피 나이데 음호 안전탕 바 안나 봉업랭 바 everyone in that movie.
Yes.
Oh my god.
So good.
Well, cảm ơn các bạn đã xem video này. Nếu các bạn xem phim Bố Già rồi, nhớ bình luận ở dưới cho Khoi với Kelly biết các bạn nghĩ gì về phim đó. Hẹn gặp lại các bạn.
Thank you. Hẹn gặp lại các bạn trong video kế tiếp.
Tạm biệt.